Hello, collectors. Welcome to episode 21 of Statue Talk. I'm your host, Joe Prodzik. Now, Statue Talk is a show where I share my thoughts and opinions on upcoming statue previews, pre-orders, and updates to my collection. Now, normally I'm joined by my co-host, Quang Tran, but he's still out in Vegas this weekend, so this episode, I'm going to be riding solo. So thanks for joining me on this week's episode. Hit the music. So as you may have noticed, I'm flying solo in this week's episode. Quang Tran is still out house sitting in Las Vegas. I actually joined him there last week. So this week it's just going to be me. A nice pint of beer. This is actually Boddington's Pub Ale from the UK. So I'm going to have a couple of these while talking about statues with you this week. So Quang is out in Las Vegas where I actually joined him last weekend. He's out there house sitting for his sister. So we had a nice house set up for our trip last weekend. So I joined him last weekend out there for the UFC 202, Conor McGregor fighting Nate Diaz. So got to check out that fight. Lots of great fights out on that card. So Quang and I were roaming around Las Vegas last weekend. Wasn't really your typical Vegas trip, right? It was more of a UFC trip. So we didn't get too crazy last weekend. Had a lot of stuff happen this month. Especially money wise, the air conditioner breaking just completely just killed my budget, and most of my extra spending money that I had set aside for the Vegas trip was completely taken up by the air conditioner. But it's fixed, it's all good. You know, we still had a great weekend. First night I flew out there, Quang and I went out for a nice steak dinner. I made him drink an old fashioned, which he wasn't too pleased about. Whenever I go out to a nice restaurant for dinner, I always like to try their old fashions because they make them a little bit differently every place. This one made them really, really strong. And so after drinking one, I was buzzing a little bit. Quang was really buzzing too. He absolutely hated it. So he took a one sip of it and then he just downed the whole thing. So we were feeling pretty good, had some good steaks. Had some really good French fries at this place too. Some tuna tartare. It was really good to have a sit down and have a nice meal. You know, Quang and I doing something different besides sitting in my downstairs bedroom talking about statues. Saturday was the night of the fights. So we started out the day. We're gonna go to some fancy place for lunch out in Vegas, but instead, I popped up some food places on my Google Maps app. Said they had this Korean and Mexican food fusion place, kind of a little hole in the wall place by where Quang lived. So I had some killer, I think it's called bulgogi tacos. It's like a Korean style meat stuffed in a corn tortilla. So that was a killer meal. I probably liked that better than I liked the expensive steak meal the night before. Then Quang and I headed out to the T-Mobile Arena, the new arena there in Las Vegas, and watched UFC. It was a really good time, some really great fights. You know, people were standing for all five rounds of that Nate and Connor fight, and it was mostly pretty amicable among the fans. I mean, I was surrounded by people from California and also people from Ireland all around me too. So I live in Manteca, which is the 209, same place that Nate Diaz is famous for being from. And I was surrounded by Irish people as well. Everybody was just getting along great. It was a heck of a fight. I agree with the decision, but I could see it going the other way. You know, it's hard for me to tell specifically. Seeing it in person is a lot different than seeing it, you know, at your TV, you can sort of analyze it more. Whereas you're there in person, you're getting caught up kind of the energy, and you can't see, you know, how well punches land versus seeing it on TV. So it was a super good time. I had a good time with Kwong out in Las Vegas. He's going to be here. He's going to be back. Should be back by next Friday, and we can start pumping out some videos together again. So other than that, I've just been hanging out playing some Deus Ex. I picked up the collector's edition of Deus Ex. Came with a little small kind of crummy statue. And then one other thing we did in Vegas is we did also go and watch Suicide Squad. I think we saw like the 11:30 showing. And I just had a big meal, had a few drinks at dinner. And so I was half falling in and out of sleep while watching Suicide Squad. So I don't know if I can give my true opinion of how that movie is and how I liked it. So far, initial impressions based on what I saw was that I really didn't like it too much, which is odd because I really like Batman versus Superman. So I didn't like the Will Smith Suicide Squad very much, and that's what it seemed like to me. So anyways, I got a lot of stuff to cover with you in this week's episode, so let's get started. All right, first up, a company called First Four Figures. I think I covered them once before with their Dark Souls statues. So, and I think they have a Metroid statue. So First Four Figures does a lot of video game statues, particularly known for their Nintendo statues, but they're starting to venture out into some different licenses like Dark Souls, Tekken, they're going to come out with some statues with. So this statue is from The Legend of Zelda, The Wind Waker. This is Link on the King of Red Lions. So this is one for all you Nintendo fans out there. And this is Link on his Red Lion sailboat. I played a little bit of this game, not too much, but it was a typical Nintendo art style. So this Link statue on his little sailboat is 25 inches tall, priced at $479.99. It's going to be available Q2 of 2017. So First Four Figures, like Sideshow, has the option for payment plans. Looks like they have 3 months, 4 months, and 5 months payment plans. So I know, $400 or $500 is expensive for some people to pay for a statue. So I like these companies that allow payment plans for their customers, so it can make it easier on someone's budget. So this is the Link on the King of Red Lions from First Four Figures. So with all the statues and pre-orders and stuff I show you today, I'll post a link in the description of the video. So if you want to go order that Link statue, go ahead and click on the link below, and that'll take you to the First Four Figures website to get some business done. So next up is a statue from Gaming Heads. This is a statue that I ordered as soon as I found out it was available. So Gaming Heads does known for their Skyrim statues, known for their Kratos on Throne statues that have been coming out, and they also have a line of Mass Effect statues as well. So this is the latest in their line from Mass Effect, which is probably my favorite video game series of all time. Played multiple playthroughs of each of those Mass Effect video games. Played so much of those games. I'm really looking forward to Mass Effect Andromeda. So I have two figures from Gaming Heads in my Mass Effect collection already. I have Liara and Garrus. And I also have the Shepard statue from Sideshow. So this is the next pre-order from Gaming Heads. This is Thane, another one of the companions from Mass Effect 2. And then he also does show up in Mass Effect 3 as well. Not as a party member, but sort of the follow-up on his story. So he's an assassin, really cool character in the game. I didn't use him much, honestly, as one of my companions, but I plan on buying this entire Mass Effect line from Gaming Heads. So I'm still waiting on a Liara from them, as well as Morden from them. Should be coming out within the next couple of months. And this is the Thane statue. So these statues are pretty reasonably priced. The exclusive version of Thane is $329.99. And he stands about 18.5 inches tall. So the exclusive edition comes with an alternate pose that shows the assassin with his trusty M4 Shuriken submachine gun by his side. So reasonably priced. Gaming Heads does do a small payment plan. So they do 2 months by $100 and then a final payment plan. So that would be a 3 month payment plan. As far as Gaming Heads goes, I was really, really liked their Garrus statue. And I was a little let down by their Liara statue. So I do have Tally and Morden coming up. So I'll let you know how those statues are when they come out. And then if you want to pre-order this Thane statue, again, a link in the in the description of the video below if you want to go over to the Gaming Heads website. Now, they have been getting some... Gaming Heads has been getting a little bit of heat about their... I lost his name. Kratos on Throne. They have been having a hard time shipping them. So I've never had a hard time getting stuff shipped from Gaming Heads. They charge me. They ship it right away. And I actually get it pretty quickly. You know, again, I'm not that far from San Francisco. So when stuff gets shipped overseas, I'm usually within a couple of days of getting it anyway. But one other thing I do like about Gaming Heads is if you get a particular edition number, let's say, I'm not sure if this is a number, but let's say I have 220 in my Garrus statue. Well, they would have sent me 220 of my Liara statue, and they would have sent me the same number for every statue I get from them from now on. In this line, they're going to send me the exact same number. So really, it doesn't increase the value of the statue or anything crazy like that, but it is a little nice touch from Gaming Head. So, I'm looking forward to more Mass Effect statues from then, and I'm looking forward to this Thane statue too. Oh, a couple statues from Connecticut. Connecticut is known for their Street Fighter statues. I think they're known for their 1/6 scale dioramas. They had an Evil Ryu that came out, and they had a Ken statue that came out. So this is a preview of their next 1/6 scale diorama. It's called the Tiger versus Jaguar. So this diorama is going to be two statues that you buy separately, put them together to make a diorama. I think they're doing that with the Ken statue and Ryu, and I think they might have a Akuma Gouken or something thrown in there. I don't know the exact details of that one. But this is Sagat versus Adon. So far, really cool looking Street Fighter statues. I'm on a big Street Fighter kick lately, but I'm collecting more quarter scales. So this is a 1/6 scale, a little bit smaller statues than what we're traditionally buying from other companies. But so far, I've been impressed with what Connecticut's is doing. I really like the idea of having two statues or more statues than that coming together to form a sort of a diorama. These are going to be action posed versus museum posed. So I think it's a really cool idea that Connecticut is doing this, giving us a little something different. Then we're also seeing from Connecticut, this is the Evil Ryu statue that they're doing. I think this is part of a diorama too. They're doing regular Ryu, Evil Ryu, and then it's going to come with a Dago statue as well that you can throw in there. So Dago, known for being a one of the top Street Fighter players, won a couple of Evos, and he's known for playing Ryu. So this I think it's called the Battle of the Beasts is what that's called. And we've seen a little bit of the concepts for this before, and this looks like part of Evil Ryu being printed up. So I'll share more information on both those two dioramas on the channel and on our Facebook page when those come up. Now I'm going to show you a couple of statues from Kotobukiya. Kotobukiya, known for their smaller scale statues. First up is a work in progress. This is the Batman and Robin statues that they're working on. You can see pretty cool looking Batman and Robin statue. It'd be interesting to see them painted up. And then now we have Miles Morales, Spider-Man from Kotobukiya. They're doing a bunch of the modern Spider-Man characters, Spider-Gwen, Spider-Man, Spider-Man 29, a little set of Spider-Man statues. So this is the Miles Morales. And I do have a couple Kotobukiya statues in my collection. They do smaller 1/10 scale statues, and they're generally pretty cheap, around $50 to $60. So it's good for collectors on a budget or anybody who wants smaller scale sort of accent pieces for their collection. You know, I've seen some collectors who have the big quarter scale statues, and all around them they have like these smaller 1/6 scale Bowens or 1/10 scale Kotobukiyas, and just kind of can fill in a lot of that empty space in a collection. So I'll let you know the Spider-Man statue, Miles Morales, should be available on the Kotobukiya website already. And it is $59.99. Artifacts Plus statue. It's about 13 inches tall in 1/10 scale. So they're doing a nice Spider-Man line. So this is the Miles Morales version. $60 over at the Kotobukiya store. Next up, I have a couple of beasts from Prime One Studios. First is a pre-order that you may have initially missed. It's been out for a couple weeks now. The exclusive is actually already sold out, but the regular version is still available. You can jump on the waitlist for the exclusive version. Chances are it's going to convert. But this is Prime One's second in their Transformers Generation 1 line. This is Megatron. All hail Megatron, right? So they first released Optimus for pre-order, and now this is the Megatron to go along with it. Like I said, the exclusive sold out fast. So if you weren't paying attention to the Statue Review Facebook page or to the Sideshow website, you might have missed out on that exclusive version of Megatron. So don't wait for this stuff to come out on the videos. Make sure you're paying attention to Facebook and Statue Review website and Sideshow's own website. Stay up to date on those pre-orders because they come out fast and they can go fast. So, Megatron statue by Prime One Studio. He's priced at $969, and you can put him on payments plans for about $109 per month. So the exclusive bonus with this statue was going to be a little purple sword for Megatron. He looked awesome next to that Optimus Prime. So Megatron looks really, really super cool. I would love to have a couple of Transformers in my collection, but now it's just not the right time for me to be ordering $1,000 statues. But it does look really cool. I think Optimus and Megatron, sort of more classic versions of the characters, because they've done the movie versions before. These are more like classic versions from the cartoon. So these do look really cool. I'd love to have them. So if you want to order Megatron, or I think Optimus is still available as well, click on the link in the description below to get that taken care of. Now I have a couple of statues from Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Out of the Shadows. There's a couple of statues that a lot of people have been waiting for. We already saw the turtles come out from this movie. Lots of people have that four turtle set. So now we have Bebop and Rocksteady from that movie. Now, I haven't seen the movie. I heard it's not very good. I will still probably watch it. But I still love the character designs in the movie, even though if it's not that well written or that well made. So this is, you can buy Bebop and Rocksteady separately, or you can buy them as a set. So the Bebop and Rocksteady set is $1,199.99 for the two statues. A limited edition of 350, and you can do payment plans for as little as $135 a month. So separately, Rocksteady is $599.99, and Bebop is the same price, $599.99. So $1,200. Doesn't look like you get any sort of discount for ordering them both. So, but cool. If you're going to have one, you got to have them both though, right? Bebop and Rocksteady kind of go together as a pair. But again, these look really good. Prime One Studios have been doing good stuff with their turtles, with Bebop and Rocksteady. So if you want to go put these on pre-order, I'll post links in the description of the video below. See, now we got some previews from Prime One Studio. First up is a little teaser from their G.I. Joe line. We're seeing a little bit of Destro here. And I think they're going to be... I'm looking forward to this line probably the most from Prime One. I was really a big G.I. Joe fan as a kid. I'm looking forward to seeing more from this line. And it might be a line that causes me to open my wallet up a little bit. Next, we're seeing a little preview. This is looks like a digital sculpt of the Joker. Not sure exactly what version of the Joker this is from. I know they're planning on doing an Origins version. This doesn't kind of quite seem like that version to me, but I'm looking forward to seeing what they do with the Joker statue. Now, next teaser, we're seeing a little bit of a Witcher statue here. And this looks like it's Triss from The Witcher. So I'm really looking forward to seeing that line of statues from Prime One as well. Again, that's a line. I don't know if I would collect the whole line, but I might collect maybe at least a Geralt statue. I really did enjoy that video game. So that's it this week from Prime One Studios. So now let's cover a couple little teasers from Pop Culture Shock before we get over to the big pre-order that's coming up. So first, we're going to take a look at a sculpted Chun-Li that they've been working on. Now, if you follow Pop Culture Shock on Instagram, they post actually a lot of videos of their work in progress of this 1/3 scale Chun-Li statue. So check out the Instagram of Pop Culture and you can see all the videos. I'm just going to post up a quick picture here. This is looking to be a dynamite statue. You know, Chun-Li is looking very muscular, but also still very feminine and sexy looking as well. So I really like that. We're seeing a head sculpt of what looks like to be a jury statue. It'd be interesting to see if this is going to be what game this is going to be based on. But I am looking forward to seeing this. I'll probably get her. She's not one of my favorite characters, but I do think I need a female character in my Street Fighter line. I'm going to buy the whole line from Street Fighter V. So if she's from, she's in that game, so I'll probably pick it up anyway. Now we're seeing a little teaser of Ryu. This is from Street Fighter V. This is part of their 1/6 scale V-Trigger line. So it's looking really cool, really good. This line is fully sculpted, so it's not going to have the mixed media that their quarter scales do. I think this would be nice to have next to that quarter scale Ryu statue. You have quarter scale, you have 1/6 scale V-Trigger, and if you want, you can put that 1/3 scale that's going to come out as well. Now, we're taking a look coming soon at the M. Bison life-size bust. Again, if you've been following PCS on Instagram, you've seen this in process, the work in progress of this this statue. Now, I've been really impressed with the busts from Pop Culture Shock, especially the Akuma bust that came out. They're also working on a Sub-Zero bust from Mortal Kombat X as well. This one looks to be really cool. You know, something I'm thinking about in the back of my mind, even though I don't do busts, I think this would... may be a great centerpiece for the Street Fighter line. So it's something I got in the back of my mind. So he'll be coming up for pre-order soon, and we'll cover that in the channel and on the Facebook page as well. Now we got a pre-order coming up from Pop Culture Shock. Pre-order is going to be Monday, August 29th. So it's going to be quickly after this video goes live. Monday, August 29th at 3 p.m. Pacific time. Now they said, so this next statue is from their Ultra line of Street Fighter statues, which is said to have been selling well. So the Ultra line is a more action-oriented line. They're more dynamic poses to the line, and they have, you know, the regular Street Fighter line for Pop Culture Shock has the simple black bases. Well, this has a little bit more height to it, and a little bit more, it's a little bit more artistic than their museum style bases. So this is a character that a lot of people have been waiting for a new statue of, and I was excited for it too. This is the Zangief quarter scale ultra statue. Now, I don't know if I'm going to get this statue. I don't actually think I am, even though Zangief does look really good here. It looks like a really good sculpt. Looks like a really cool statue. But I think I am going to focus on that museum-style Street Fighter statue with the black base rather than the Ultra statue. I have ordered one Ultra statue. I ordered the Vega statue, but I passed on the Cammy. So I don't think I'm going to pursue that line. I think I'm going to stick to the more traditional line of Street Fighter statues. So they have a regular retail version of the statue priced at $529.99. Open edition size. They haven't decided the edition size on this yet. They'll do that later. So the retail version, you know, isn't going to be the most sought after version, but you'll be able to buy it at different websites around the web in addition to the PCS website. So Zangief is supposed to be about 27 inches tall. He's estimated to ship in fourth quarter of 2017, which means we'll get him sometime in 2018. Now, they do have the PCS Siberian Express exclusive statue. So this one is only available at PopCultureShockToys.com. He's limited to 275 pieces. He's the same price, $529.99. He includes an interchangeable open mouth portrait. So that's what the exclusive is, as well as a signed art print by Edwin Huang and a certificate of authenticity. So that is the Siberian Express exclusive. So just basically the normal version with the switched out head and an art print. So next up is the PCS V-Trigger exclusive. Interesting that they included Zangief's V-Trigger in this line, because traditionally their V-Trigger line from Street Fighter V is smaller scale, 1/6 scale. So this is a quarter scale V-Trigger statue. So he's got, you know, pink all over. He also has the open mouth portrait and the signed art print. Same price, $529.99. So next up, we have the PCS Mecha Zangief exclusive. This one is limited to 125 pieces. And same price, $529.99. Again, interchangeable portrait and a signed art print for that. So Zangief is one of those old school Street Fighter statues. It's really popular. Sells for, you know, $2,500, $3,000. And I think the Mecha version goes for even more. So it's one of the most sought after Street Fighter statues. Yeah, for me, I'm a little disappointed it's not a part of the Ultra line. But I know somewhere down the road, they're going to make a Street Fighter V version of this one that I'm going to pick up. So I'm actually, for me, I'm going to wait for that version, I think. Although, you know, come Monday, it's often hard for me to resist the excitement of these PCS pre-orders. But I think I'm going to try to do that. Looks super, super good. Looks like a big statue. So 27 inches is pretty big. Almost as big as Lobo is. And he's kind of a pain in the butt to find a spot for. But yeah, it does look really cool and really good. So that's it. This week from PCS. I'll post a link in the description. That pre-order goes live on Monday, August 29th at 3 p.m. Now, next up, we have some pre-orders from Sideshow Collectibles. Now, the first pre-order that we have up is the Killer Croc premium format figure. Now, the exclusive version is still available on this Killer Croc statue. So if you want to get that, they haven't set an edition size yet. So you don't set an edition size, it can't really sell out. So this is the Killer Croc. And let's see if we can see what the exclusive is. Exclusive version features a swap out portrait that is more crocodile in appearance. So the exclusive version is the switch out portrait. This was an instant order for me. I collect the Batman line from Sideshow. That's a line that I'm going to keep getting all the figures for. The only one I'm missing is that Joker. So I really like the look of this Killer Croc. I'm not sure about that exclusive portrait, as the head seems a little small against the body. But either way, you know, as long as I have that regular portrait, hey, it's good to go for me. So this looks really cool. Really great character from Batman. I'm glad that we're getting at least two Batman villains this year. Bane to come out later this year. So Killer Croc is priced at $519.99. Pant plans as little as $58.50. So yeah, really love this Killer Croc. Again, I'm not sold on that portrait. It does have mixed media pants. I think he's going to look great with that next to all those other Batman statues from that line. I think it's going to look really good. Now, the next pre-order from Sideshow is the Michelangelo statue, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Now, if you're looking for the exclusive version with red bandanas on this piece, you probably missed out already. Sideshow has been doing some of these pre-orders a little bit differently. So on Wednesday, if you're one of the people who ordered the Leonardo statue, you may have gotten an email from Sideshow to order the statue early. In my case, I did get that email. I was able to order the exclusive. But when Michelangelo went up for sale to the general public on Thursday, he was actually sold out already. I think that the exclusive version was limited to only about 500 pieces. So the turtle line from Sideshow looks to be really popular. It's a you know, it's interesting to know if that's if it's popular because people like it, or people are just thinking about that old set of classic turtle comiquettes, you know, which run from about $600, $700 to even $1,000 per turtle. And those were originally around $200 each. So they've gone up significantly in value, and they're expensive statues to have. I used to have the set myself, but you know, I kept seeing $3,500 sitting on my shelf. I was like, I got to get rid of those turtles. They'll come out with some more eventually, and they are doing that. So the difference is this collection of turtles is Sideshow's own design. So these aren't from Nickelodeon. These aren't from the comic books. They don't look like they're traditional turtles. They're sort of a different take on the character. And I'm really digging them. I really want to have a bigger set of turtles in my collection. I have the set from Good Smile that's really small scales turtles. And again, those are a different take on the turtles too. So I'm all open for different takes, different artist takes on characters. So these turtles are reasonably priced, $349.99. You probably jump on the wait list for that exclusive and still get one. But if not, the regular version is readily available. He'll have the orange bandana and not the red bandanas. So limited time offer on the Sideshow website, free U.S. shipping and up to $35 back in rewards. So they're getting giving good deals on this these turtles. So he's expected to ship June to August of 2017. So that's pretty good. You can do payment plans for him as well, around $52 a month. So that's the Michelangelo statue, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles from Sideshow. I'm planning on getting the set. I just hope that they make more characters as well, instead of just the four turtles. Classic Comiquettes, they only made, they made the turtles, and they made a Shredder, and then they made some Mausers. So I would like to see some additional characters. I think that would be really cool. Also from Sideshow Collectibles is the Angela premium format figure. Again, exclusive is available on this one. Edition size is yet to be determined. So, I don't know a lot about this character, Angela. I know she's from Guardians of the Galaxy. I don't really know anything about her. So, Sideshow exclusive version includes a spear and an additional guiding hand. So, it's from Guardians of the Galaxy. Don't know anything about the character, so she won't be for me, but this looks like a really, really beautiful statue. Sideshow has been doing their female statues, comic book statues, really, really well. So she's going to look great in any collection. I think she's really cool. She's priced at $499.99. And she's expected to ship May to July of 2017. Payment plans as low as $56 a month. So if you want to order any of these Sideshow statues, I'm going to post links in the description of the video. So if you want to go get some business done with Sideshow, go ahead and click on those links. Now, full disclosure, those are affiliate links down there for Sideshow. So if you do click on one of my links and you buy one of these statues, they are going to throw a couple of dollars my way, which will go towards just supporting the channel, paying for website fees, all that kind of stuff. I haven't actually made any money from any of those affiliate fees yet so far. So, you know, you don't get charged any money. But I wanted to give full disclosure that that's out there. All the other companies are just regular links to their website. So just wanted to let you guys know that before you click on those links. So that's it this week from Sideshow Collectibles. All right, last but not least, let's cover some XM Studios. XM Studios has been showing a lot of teasers lately, but they're ramping up for STGCC, which is like the Singapore Comic-Con. They're going to be showing a lot of statues over there. So I will not be at Singapore Comic-Con. I can't even make it to Comic-Con this year. But hopefully we'll get to see a lot of pictures and previews of some of their upcoming statues. So let's run through some teasers here. First up, we have Iron Fist. Statue I'm really looking forward to seeing more of. I'm not a huge fan of the character, but I am a huge fan of XM's work and XM sculpts. Iron Fist is looking really, really good. Then we're going to take a look at their digital sculpts for their Joker statue. So this Joker statue is in line with the Samurai Batman, the cat, different looking Catwoman, sort of a Japanese style, kind of a Yakuza look, I guess. So a completely different take on those characters. Interesting and unique. You know, lots of Batman, Joker statues out there that are pretty much very, very similar, right? Traditional Batman, traditional Joker. Yeah, they're all a little bit different, but they're basically the same. So I like XM is taking risks. They're doing something a little bit differently. I'm personally not digging concept. I kind of like that Batman, Samurai Batman that they did. But this isn't like a whole line that I would collect in my collection. I prefer the more traditional style sculpts, but it is looking very interesting, very unique take on the Joker. I like his sort of chain that he has here. Ha! Kind of reminds me a little bit of how he was in Suicide Squad. Now we get to see their work in process of Mr. Sinister. This is going to be a statue that's going to be hard to resist for me. A really cool character. And again, this is the very basic initial stages of the character. So, you know, XM does a lot of dynamic poses. So this is a very stagnant pose. That's not what it's going to be so far. So they'll do up the character, then they'll pose him and do something different, I'm sure. Now we get to see a little bit more of that Sentinel base. So the Sentinel base is a smaller scale statues that you put together into one big, huge diorama. Hopefully we get to see that painted up at STGCC. Now we're seeing their Beta Ray Bill. Beta Ray Bill, again, another character I'm not a huge fan of, and that's what XM Studios is doing. a lot of different characters, a lot of side characters, a lot of B characters, C characters, and they're making awesome statues of it. And that's what we have for me and Beta Ray Bill. Now, if you're a comic book fan, you know Beta Ray Bill. Everybody knows Beta Ray Bill if you read Marvel Comics. But it's not typically a character you see a lot of statues made of. But this looks really, really super cool. And if you're a fan of Beta Ray Bill, you're going to be really happy about this one, I think. Now we're seeing the lizard. They got him painted up a little bit. Looking forward to seeing that. I know Kwong is looking forward to seeing that. He's a big Spider-Man fan. Those villains that they're doing from their Spider-Man line are looking really, really cool. And hoping to see more painted versions of that at STGCC. Now, this is a statue. The big dog that got put on the shelf, got put on hold for a while. And now he's back. So Cable. This Cable's looking killer, man. I want to put this Cable in my cabinets, man. That Cable is a killer. You know, it's just a tough ask to order XM statues for me still. Just because, you know, you end up paying probably about $1,200 per statue. Just because shipping is, even if I, you know, I know someone now who can, you get me the statue for cost, even though, you know, if I'm paying cost for the statue, I still got to pay $250 for shipping. And the reason is the XM packaging is so awesome and so heavy duty, and it's going to ensure your statue doesn't break at all. But it costs a lot of money to ship that sucker overseas, you know. This Cable, though, it looks really, really good. Really cool character. I love Cable. Time traveling. He's just a badass. And this statue, we've known this was going to be great for a long time. XM Studios actually had to put it on hold for a while. I think all their X-Men characters had to be put on hold for a while. It's just something Marvel was doing with a lot of their different licenses. Fantastic Four. You don't see a lot of there's a reason why you don't see a lot of merchandise for a lot of these Marvel movies that aren't made by Marvel, like the Fantastic Four movies, the X-Men movies. You go to the store, you see a bunch of toys for those. Because Marvel still holds the merchandising rights, or they at least have to get a cut of the merchandising rights. So there's something going on there where it doesn't make sense for them to put out a bunch of toys and merchandise for them. And so I think this had something a little bit to do with that, but I can't be sure exactly, not being behind the scenes. But Cable looks, man, the textures they put on their costumes, fully sculpted, it looks really, really good. So I'm looking forward to seeing some more from STGCC, hopefully. We get some pics in that we can share. I would love it if XM Studios posted a bunch of pictures of their booth on their website. So, or not really on the website, but usually they post it on their Facebook page. So hopefully we see a lot of pictures from that and we can share them with you here on the show. But XM Studios doing dynamite things. I just wish they were a little bit more accessible here in the United States. But killer, killer work. All right, that's it for this week's previews and pre-orders. Now let's take a look at my collection update. What's going on in my collection? Not a whole lot. I really need to actually spend some time cleaning up my collection room because I have boxes everywhere. I got the Batman Prime 1 busts box over here. I got the Arkham Knight busts still here. I need to do his review. Got the Wolverine box. My living room has the Rocky box, Kwong's symbiote Spidey box. I just have crap everywhere. I got a small bedroom downstairs, so all the crap I have to do for shooting this channel is just hanging out everywhere. You can see I have comic books piled up and different stuff here. So I need to spend some time organizing my room. So what I'm actually going to do, I don't really like the sides here. They don't kind of flow very well for me. So I'm going to try to move some stuff around a little bit, get it to flow a little bit more. I'm actually going to take two of my two cube Bestas, move those out to my living room. So I was going to put a couple of my movie statues out there. Because, you know, it's the commonplace. We have guests over. We have different things. And I just felt like the movie characters would fit more out in kind of the entertainment area, the place you go to watch movies, right? So I was planning on putting my T-800 in there, which he was probably going to lose his spot at some point anyway. And then I'm going to put that Rocky II statue out there as well. And one Besta, I'm not sure what I'm going to do in the other Besta. So that Rocky II statue, I actually ended up selling on eBay. But the buyer just didn't pay for it. So he never got paid for it. He never got shipped out. And so now I'm thinking about keeping him again, because that idea entered my head of moving some of those Bestas out in the living room. And so I was like, oh, what statues should I put in there that would look decent in our living room? Well, movie statues. I was like, oh, I could put Arnold down there, Terminator. And hey, I have that Rocky statue still. So I think I'm not going to sell that. I'm going to open it up. Still one of my favorite movies. I was really gonna sell him because he kind of doesn't fit the collection as a whole. But, you know, when I had that thought of putting him someplace else, he can be in my collection just in a different part, a different displayed area of the collection. So it makes sense now in my mind to keep him. So that's really cool. I did pre-order a couple of statues, pre-ordered that Michelangelo exclusive, and I pre-ordered the Killer Croc. I also pre-ordered the Thane statue. So lately I've been just really thinking about the consistency of my collection and everything fitting together cohesively. So I wanted to narrow it down and just concentrate on a couple of lines instead of trying to buy everything under the sun. You know, I'm just going to keep it to a couple of lines. I'm going to do the Gotham, the Batman line from Sideshow. So I'll get Killer Croc, Bane, anything else to release. I need to get that Joker at some point as well. I'm going to do the Street Fighter line from Pop Culture Shock. But I'm going to keep it modern, right? I'm not going to try to go back and get those old school pieces. Though there are a couple that I like that I do want to add. You know, E. Honda just came out. I want to add him. I was thinking about Dalsim, but I think I'll wait for the Street Fighter V version of him. And then I also ordered a Gouken statue from Pop Culture Shock. In their newsletter, they have something called what's the Warehouse Gems. So that's extra stock of stuff they have and they find. And you can click on it and order it. So a Gouken has been sold out for a while. I clicked on the Warehouse Gem. I already had him on my watch list on eBay. I was thinking about buying him. And I got him for cost from Pop Culture Shock too. And the great thing about that is he's going to be an artist proof. And I got him for cost. So I really did like the Pilgrim version, but I'm getting the regular version of Gouken. So I'll be able to put him with Ryu and Ken. Should look really good. So I'm going to continue on that Street Fighter line from Pop Culture Shock, Street Fighter V, Street Fighter IV. I'm going to pass on the Ultra line, and I think I'm going to cool it on the 1/3 scales from them as well. I got Akuma coming. I got a Battle Ryu coming. So those will be good. What other line? Mass Effect. I'm going to continue to collect the Mass Effect line from Gimme Heads. You know, one of my favorite video game series of all time. So I'm going to continue with that line. And then I'll continue with Marvel statues, you know, just general Marvel statues. We'll probably get most stuff from Sideshow. But there's going to be stuff like that I'm not going to get. Like, I'm not going to get the Guardians of the Galaxy. I'm not going to get characters that I don't really know or really enjoy. Just going to get characters that I like. Then I may throw in a couple of XM statues or two. I could pay for Doctor Strange. He should be on the way. And then I also have a Black Panther on order. So I might get one or two XM statues. Really, really debating about that Cable. So, but we'll see how it goes. I'm also going to get the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles from Sideshow. I'm just not going to buy everything under the sun like I was before. I want to add some consistency to my collection. I might get some more DC characters as well. I was thinking about that Prime 1 DC line. We'll have to see what the cost is going to be on those statues, when they're going to come out, etc. Because what I do is I have a spreadsheet of my pre-orders, and it's a little budget. It says what's supposed to come out each month and what I have on pre-order for each month. So I give myself a certain budget for that month, and I don't really try not to go over it. But lately in the past year, I've been going over it a lot. So I want to kind of trim that back a little bit. You know, we're in a two-story house now. My wife is actually disabled, so we need to switch to a one-story house probably sometime next year. So got to put some money, a little bit more money away for that. And just, you know, different things. I just want to keep it down. I shoot for about two statues a month within that range. But, you know, you get an XM statue, that's the price of, you know, more than two traditional quarter-scale statues. You get a Prime 1 statue, that's the same thing. So I have to take that into account, and just trying to keep it more consistent and more sort of reasonable. So I did end up canceling some statues as well after I decided to do that. So these are movie-based statues. Sorry, family's interrupting me. So I canceled some of my movie-based statues, The Dark Knight and The Joker from the Christopher Nolan trilogy. Not a huge fan of that trilogy. And they're movie-based statues, and I'm trying to stay away from movie-based statues generally. I canceled the Batmans, both the armored Batman, the regular Batman from Batman vs. Superman. Even though I did love that movie, I do like Ben Affleck as Batman. I'm just concentrating more on comic book-style characters rather than movie characters. I was going to get every Batman under the sun, but like I said, I want some more consistency in my statues. And honestly, that Dark Knight was going to be paid and shipped like a couple days before I was set to go to Vegas. Like I said, the air conditioner hit, Vegas trip hit, something had to give, and it was that Dark Knight statue. So many statues were going to come out and hit me in August. Spider-Man, Iron Studios Spider-Man. Had to take that off the list as well. Just, you know, sometimes when you pre-order statues, right, you put your plan together, and then sometimes I won't get a statue for a couple of months. You're just sitting there dry, and I do crazy things like create talk shows, you know, on YouTube during those periods. Or, you know, I'll get five statues in a week. And you're like, whoa, this is really too much. It's overwhelming the amount of statues you get, and you can't enjoy each individually because you've got so many. So that's just the way collecting is. So I will keep you guys up to date on how I decide to rearrange my room. And once I'm done with that, I'll show you another collection update. One thing I do want to focus the channel more on is actual statue reviews. See, this channel is called Statue Review, right? So we've got to get back to doing what I created the channel to do in the first place, which was reviews of statues, not unboxings, not talk shows or anything like that. Though I still will be doing those. I just want to make sure I get those good objective reviews out to you with the close-ups of the statue top to bottom, so you can decide if you like the statue or not, if you want to add it to your collection, or you know, just like looking at statues because maybe you can't buy one. So at whatever reason it is you like to watch those videos, you know, I want to keep putting them out for you. So I want to concentrate to make that a focal point of the channel over the next couple of months. So we got the Arkham Knight review going to shoot next week. Then I'm going to do Wolverine. And Kwong's going to do his first review, Symbiote Spidey. And then eventually we'll get to the Rocky statue at some point as well. So that's what's going on in my collection lately. Just waiting on a couple statues that should be coming soon. That Gouken, just paid for the shipping. Doctor Strange is on his way. That rumor is Death Dealer on Horse from ARH Studios. Should be shipping out within the next couple of weeks too. So lots of good stuff. It's been a busy summer. It's gonna just keep flowing. I think I have a Tally and Morden from Gaming Heads should be coming out fairly soon too. So lots of stuff going on. Lots of statues incoming. I'll be sure to share all of them with you here on the channel. So in this week's question of the week, I have a question for you viewers. What do you think about alternate portraits? What's your opinion about alternate portraits? Lots of companies like Sideshow, Pop Culture Shock include them in their exclusive versions. A lot of people think that they should be included in every version. Like, something that they did with the Prime 1 Batman piece. He comes with one head, but then you have to buy a couple more separately in a separate package. So Red Hood, Arkham Knight came with two heads right out the gate. That's the exclusive version. So do you like alternate portraits? Should they be the exclusive version? Or should we have to buy them separately? And then you have custom portraits. Lots of people making custom portraits for statues. Do you think those are better? Do you buy them? What do you think? I don't have a... Personally, I don't have a lot of custom portraits. I don't think I have a single custom portrait. But I do have a lot of alternate portraits from my exclusive versions of the statues. And while I like them, I'll be honest with you, I never switch them out. Batman has an alternate portrait. I don't ever switch it out. Lobo. I never switch them out. Harley has one. I just don't do it. I pick the one that I like best and I leave it on there. And the rest sit in the closet, wedged between some styrofoam. So, let me know what you think about the alternate portraits of the statue. Are they important to you? How would you like them included in your statue? And I will be sure to share some of your answers in next week's episode, and I'll let you know what Kwong and I think about it. This week's featured video is from HeroStatueCollectorLou. This is his review of the Sideshow TMNT Comiquette sets. Now, the reason I'm sharing this video with you is because we've gotten some new turtles from Sideshow lately, and this is a review of the old school Comiquette set. It's a set that I used to own, but I actually sold it. So I never got to feature them on the channel because I sold them before I even set up the channel. So if you like the Ninja Turtles, you like stuff from Sideshow, make sure you check out this video from Hero Statue Collector Lou. I hope you enjoyed this latest episode of Statue Talk. Let me know what you think of some of the topics I covered in the comment section below. I may even share some of your comments or questions on next week's episode. Now, if you're a statue addict like me, or even a beginning collector like Kwong, and you can't wait a full 2 weeks for the latest statue news and pre-orders, make sure you give us a like on Facebook, Statue Review. Make sure you check out the Statue Review website. Guess what? www.statuereview.com. I've tried to share everything from around social media to those two places. So pictures that XM shares, Pop Culture puts on their Instagram, pre-orders that come up, I share to those places. Especially if you want one of those exclusive versions that sell out fast, make sure you check that out, because if you're waiting for me to cover it on Statue Talk, you're probably going to miss it. At least for some of the more limited ones, like those from Prime 1 and those turtles from Sideshow. So thanks for joining me on this week's episode. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Keep up to date on all of my latest unboxings and statue reviews. And remember, statue collecting is more than just a hobby. It's a lifestyle. This has been Joe Project for Statue Review. Kwong is going to be back on the episode coming out in 2 weeks. Thanks for watching.